Welcome back to the Daily Mix. Well, it's a new year, and maybe it's also time for a new career. Looking for something with animals? Well, Pima Medical Institute is your place, and joining me today is Dr. Gina Lucas, and we are talking about, of course, you guys have been having an open house, saying, come on out, today's the last day?
Today is the last day.
But this is great, because people might be looking for a new career. They probably love animals, and maybe they don't want to be a full veterinarian, but you are, of course, in charge of the veterinary tech department?
Technician program.
Okay, and we were just talking about this. What isn't a technician, a vet technician?
A technician isn't, compared to a doctor, able to diagnose, prognose, prescribe medications, or do surgery. They are allowed to do everything else. In different states, there's different scopes of practice, but in general, veterinary technicians do everything that human nurses do, but additionally, they are trained to do anesthesia, so they are the anesthesia personnel.
Yeah.
They are lab technicians, they are x-ray technicians, and they have a really wide variety of specialties that they can go into.
So after doing this, can I actually move into being a doctor, or is this more, is it kind of like a starting point?
That's a really good question. It's not a direct path, but it is a parallel path. And if you're interested in becoming a veterinarian, starting out as becoming a certified veterinary technician will do you a lot of good when it comes to applying to veterinary school.
All right, and this is what I like, is that if you become a veterinary technician, you get to bring your a pet to school.
Yeah.
Come to class, to work with you.
To work,
so
yeah.
This is good. Who do we have here?
This is Daisy. She comes to work with me every day. And so she is sort of the East Valley campus mascot. And she's my pet. She belongs to the students as well. She goes from classroom to classroom and spreads her little smushed face and provide some happiness for the students throughout the day.
I know there's a lot of things that Pima Medical Institute offers in classes and doing things, but what also I've been learning too is that you guys have made a lot of changes where you guys are really on hands with the students, because of course you've been listening to them over the years, and that's why somebody might be scared about their getting back into school, maybe at an older age, but you guys are like, no, we're here to actually work with you, and that's what you want people to come out and see today.
Exactly. We have a very wide range of ages of students, from 18. We have a gentleman who just finished up. He was in his 60s, and he's now employed as a vet tech. And anybody can come out if you have a high school degree. That's all that's required. And if you don't have your high school graduation, we can help you with that through the GED program.
That's amazing. That's awesome.
Yeah.
All right. Again, open house today.
Open house today.
But of course, classes are always enrolling in different ways that you can.
Yeah.
And you get to come and hang out with Dr. Lucas and some great little animals too.
Yep. And so we'll also be on the 24th of January. We'll be over at the Mesa campus of EVIT, and with the high school students over there. Daisy and I will be over there, and a lot of our admissions reps.
We'll be around.
We'll be around, yeah.
I like that. All right. We'll have information on azTV.com for you. Thanks for stopping by, Doctor.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Daisy. Thank you. All right. Okay. There we go.